Yes, Lord. Yes.
And we're going to look at what perpetuation is. I want you to go to 1 John 3 and 5. Hallelujah. But now, see, I'm telling you, the Lord gave me this revelation that sin's already been dealt with.
Yes, Lord.
Uh-huh. All we have to do is deal with the revelation of the evil.
Yes. Come on.
All that's right. A residue.
Come on, Father.
Hallelujah. 1 John 3 and 5. And it reads, and ye know that he was manifested to do what? Take away our sin.
Mm-hmm.
And in him is no sin. I want you to touch that neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
He took away sin.
He took away sin.
There is no such thing as a penalty anymore.
All right.
Praise God. My God. Go with me now to 1 Peter 1, 18 through 20. And while you're going there, I want you to say the only thing that's left to be dealt with is the residue of evil. And that's my sermon topic. Hallelujah. Yes. The Lamb who taken away the sins of the world. Boy. And the subtopic is the residue of evil.
All right.
1 Peter 1, 18 through 20. For as much as ye know that ye were not redeemed with corruptible things, as silver and gold from your vain conversation received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot, who verily was foreordained before the foundation of the world, but was manifest in these last times for you. Everybody said these last times.
These last times.
Who by him do believe in God that raised him up from the dead and gave him glory that your faith and hope might be in God. Tell that neighbor, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
Sin. Has been dealt with.
And
the devil himself.
And the devil himself.
Can't bring it on me. Because it's been done away with.
It's been done away with.
You say amen.
Amen.
Logos word and situation, he turned the wrath away.
Yes.
Wrath of God. Then he's the atonement. He forgave his heart. Hallelujah. Then he's the advocate.
Yes, come on now.
My God.
Woo, Jesus. Yes. He's the advocate. We have an advocate who pleads in behalf of everyone.
Yes.
Who applies for pardon and salvation in his name.
Yes.
Depending on his pleadings for them.
That's a praise.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Then number four, we have the invitation.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus, who received his nature pure of sin and fulfilled all righteousness, all men are invited to come to God through this atoning sacrifice and by this new and living way. We have an open invitation.
Yes, we do.
Yes,
Lord.
Yes,
we can come in his house anytime.
Yes.
An open invitation. That's point number four. Number five, the Logos word, the gospel, when understood and received, sets the heart against all sin and stops the allowed practice of it. At the same time, it gives blessings and relief to those with wounded conscience for having committed sin. Well, let me tell you something. When I hear that Logos word, it liberates my spirit.
Yes.
That thing that the devil been accusing me of, I can say, get thee behind me, Satan.
Yes.
because the last one was already dealt with.
Yes. Amen.
Now,